Hey everyone, it's Joe Lyons here from the Automator, and today I'm talking again with Jean Lalonde, the author of Quick Access Popup. Today, he had a really great topic we decided we're going to cover. It's some of the most important and key things you need to know when you start using Quick Access Popup. Quick Access Popup, if you're not familiar, it's a really amazing tool to help you be more efficient, save tons of clicks and everything. I love it. We've done a lot of videos. Jean, why don't you go ahead and show us here what you've been working on.
Yes, Joe. And what we'll do today is also take this opportunity to see how Quick Access Popup works using Windows 11. You know that this new version of Windows is now available in beta mode for beta users. So I installed a copy of it on a virtual machine and run Quick Access Popup on this environment. So it will also give us an idea of how well Quick Access Popup runs in Windows 11. And it does, I can tell you. But it changes some of the visuals. And so we'll also see this in this video. Not that I want to do a Windows 11 demo, which is not... I haven't used it enough to do that, but we can at least see how it looks. So here's the new background that you have by default on Windows 11, at least with this beta release. The main change in Windows 11 is that instead of having the start button on the left side, it's now in the middle part here. Some changes also in the what is displayed and how Windows will display the various items that you selected here. But for what regards Quick Access Popup, it's quite the same. So at first, with the default configuration, this is a brand new installation of Quick Access Popup here. You have the shortcuts at the beginning that you can read or read later. And you have the customized window being displayed when you launch Quick Access Popup. And some users will ask, okay, I'm good now with my configuration and I want this window not to be displayed each time I start a window. So that's one of the things that you can change by going in the options. You have about 12 sections here where options are regrouped. There's a lot of them. It can be intimidating for at first, but what we'll do today is just to show you the main ones, those that you will appreciate knowing and put them the way you would prefer them. So first, I will, the first option maybe that you've already seen, even if you never went in the options, is that if you tried to change a folder in the dialog box, which is one of the major benefits of using or most time-saving features of Quick Access Popup. For example, if we want to save a file in Notepad and we do save as, and here in the dialog box, we want to change the folder, let's say to the C root drive. The first time you try to do that, Quick Access Popup will detect that you want to change folder in the dialog box and will ask you to enable this feature because this feature has to be enabled in the options. Why? Because there's some information being displayed when you enable this option. So do you want to open the options window where you will be able to enable this option? You click yes, and it will open the general section of the options. And you have this first option here, dialog boxes, change folder in dialog box. You click the checkbox. By the way, Windows 11 parentheses, the only difference I see is that checkboxes are now rounded and they are blue background. When you check and uncheck them, you see that's a little bit, I like this new visual in Windows 11. But when you check this dialog box option here, it will display a text telling you essentially that this feature is for file dialog boxes. So file open, file save, save as, and this menu should not be used when you are in other types of dialog boxes, just to make sure you don't affect the content of these dialog boxes. So use it when you open or when you save a file. When you understand that, you click OK, then the option is now enabled and you will be able to save it. So that's the first option. That's one that's really important to enable, to benefit really from this feature of Quick Access Popup. Some other options here, run at startup. It is by default enabled. When you use the setup program, it does that for you. I recommend to keep it that way. And check for update option that will help you being aware of new version of Quick Access Popup will also be very useful. Other options here, you can take a look at that later if you wish. So that's in the general section. In the customize window section, so the customize window, let me save this and show you. The customize window is this window here, when you can add favorites, when you can move them, where you can use drag and drop to change items in the order of the items, all these features here, that's the customize window. So by default, this option is enabled, but when you're good with your menu, you don't need this window to be displayed each time you launch Quick Access Popup. So you can uncheck this open customize window at QRP. Open the customize window at the QAP startup. So then what you will be able to do is to open the customize window when you need it. So if we save these options here, and when you open the menu, you will see that you have the customize menu here, which is doing that. So if the window is closed, we can click anywhere and open the customize window just when you need to add or move something to your menu. So that's the main option that you need to know here, and it will make Quick Access Popup more discreet if you don't need to be always displayed. The other option that I find interesting is if you work with multiple monitors, it is good to have the menu and the customized window to open on the monitor you are working on. So this is this option here, open customize window on active monitor. That is checked by default. You can uncheck that if you prefer to have Quick Access Popup always open on the same monitor, and Quick Access Popup will remember where it was open the last time. So these are the two options in under the customized window that I wanted to mention. The third section here, menu icons. The thing that can be good if you like it is to make your icons smaller. So by default here, the icons have 32 pixels wide and high. They are square. So you can change it. Oops, I checked it by my accident. So you can make it smaller here, choosing 16. So I will save it. It needs to restart Quick Access Popup when you change the icon size. And I'll open the menu. So you see the menu is much smaller. So when you have a lot of items, it's good. I prefer personally to use it with this size here. You could even ask Quick Access Popup not to display icons at all by unchecking this dialog box here if you prefer. And if on the opposite, you prefer large icons, maybe for visibility or for visual reasons. Excuse my English, not sure which word to use here. So I'll show you the opposite here with the menu will be very large.
But the thing to remember is...
And when it is very large, Joe, just to explain that there you have arrows where you can scroll in the part of the menu that you don't see. Yes.
Yeah, for someone who has a 4K monitor, though, it's hard to remember. Those are going to be much smaller, right? They're going to appear much smaller because you have so much more screen space.
Yeah, it can be good for them to make it larger. Yeah. So I'll revert here to the 32 pixel size, which is a default. And the last part that I want to show you is about the trigger of the menus. By default, Quick Access Popup is the menu is triggered using the middle mouse button, okay, that you don't see that I click here to open this menu. You could change it. And also you could say that in some application, you would prefer not to have the menu to be popped up, because the menu can be popped up by default anywhere. So I can be on the taskbar, I can be inside Notepad, I can be on the desktop, it will open the menu. But some program will use the middle mouse button for something that you find important for you, and you would prefer, for example, let's say that in Photoshop, we do not pop up the menu. So there's a way to prevent that, and that's the two things I will show you. First, you could decide just to use another trigger than the middle button. So that's what we will see first. So in the options, we go in the pop-up hotkeys here. So the first option is for the mouse button that will open Quick Access Popup. You can change it and choose any button that is available on your mouse. So except the left mouse button, because it's used to do so many other things that you don't want the left mouse button to be taken by Quick Access Popup. But you could say that you want the left mouse button with shift or with control, or with control shift if you want the two hotkeys to be pressed. So I'll just show you now, and you won't see it, but using control left mouse button, it will now trigger the Quick Access Popup menu. So the middle mouse button does nothing. If I was in Chrome, it would scroll the window. But if I press control and left click, it opens the menu. Same thing can be done for the keyboard. Yes, Joe?
Well, I was going to say, I know a lot of your users are power users, right? And they're probably like me, and they have a mouse that has more than three buttons. And so yeah. I use one of those special twos that you had listed there. And it's great because I don't have to use up any of my other ones, and it doesn't interfere with any program because no other program is really, you know, using those, relying on those.
So these are the two. There's one head, one in the back, maybe. So you have to find which one is one, which one is two. But these are these two special. And what I also very like very much is to use the wheel left and wheel right. So the mouse button that you click, you can also just push it to the right or push it to the left. Okay. And it can trigger the menu. And that's because when I have two instances of Quick Access Popup running at the same time for development or testing, I like to have my main using the middle mouse button, but the second one, I will choose the wheel right option, which is very convenient if your mouse supports that and if the button is not too hard to use. So it depends on your mouse. So I'll just revert it here to the default. You can click here, reset default hotkey, which is the middle mouse button for this. And you can do the same for the keyboard. So by default, it is Windows W here. If I want to change it to Windows X, I just press X here, and you could say that it is instead of Windows X, it could be Shift Control X if you prefer. And when it is the modifiers, these key here are the modifiers. You usually have one on the left, one on the right, so you can select if you want any key to do the modification, or just having the left or the right modifier to be considered here. So again, I'll revert to the default. And just as we are here, we can also enable the menu by using the double control key. So control can open the menu also. Only the left or only the right or both, as you would prefer. Oh. It's another way to open the menu. Okay, so you had a question or a
No, remark? It's okay. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Now, if you want to keep the middle mouse button, but just want to exclude it in one given application, so you can go here under pop-up menu, where you have a section allowing you to blacklist some application. So for example, I have Notepad open here. I can open the menu. Okay, I'll just save my option because I changed a few things here. Okay, so the middle mouse button will open when I am over Notepad. But if I want to exclude Notepad, and I'm taking it as an example, you go here in pop-up menu and you type Notepad here. And any window that includes Notepad in its title, Quick Access Popup will not open on this window. So I can open when I am on the desktop here, but nothing happens when I am in Notepad. And in fact, the middle mouse click is sent to Notepad. Notepad does nothing with it, but if your application does something with it, it will receive your click as if Quick Access Popup was not running. Okay, so Quick Access Popup will be available anywhere else except in this window or these windows. You can have multiple one by line if you wish. And if you're a little more technical, you can also, if you say, Notepad is a word I use in other windows, in folders, I don't want Quick Access Popup to be included in a folder that would include Notepad in its name. So in this case, you would need to use class name, and you have more information here. You can click the Get Window Info to help you. I won't go into all these details, but there you can be a little more specific here if you wish, regarding the way you exclude windows. So these are the main, there's a lot more that you can see here. And I invite you to just do a tour to see what could be of interest for you. It's all by default the way most users will probably prefer to use Quick Access Popup. If you use Total Commander or Directory Opus here, you can select these file managers, and it may be done at the beginning when you launch Quick Access Popup. It will detect that you have a preferred alternative file manager here. There are various options related to that. Snippets and Hotstring also have their options. A little more advanced thing is user variables. The database options here, so it become more technical at the end, so you don't need to understand all this, but at least
we do have a video on that one though that covers a lot of the good stuff from
the covered the database options in a video earlier. So that's it with Joe.
Awesome, thank you so much, John. Like I said, QAP, it's an amazing tool. I would highly encourage you to read through those options and try. You don't have to use them, but just make sure you understand at least some of the stuff, like the snippets and hot strings. Like, a lot of people don't even understand what those are, and they probably don't use them yet. They're one of the most powerful things, like, to me, in my opinion. I agree, though. You started off with the open and closed save dialog box. That is an amazing part of QAP. The thing I would put right after that is the hot strings, hot keys, and snippets to be able to use. Yeah, that's amazing. So thanks again, John. Really good
thanks
stuff.
Thanks to you. Bye-bye.